in your head. One Act 2023, four shows total, three plays, one musical, and one night only. These plays are student produced, directed, acted, and written. Everything is going to be perfect. Sent from space to steal all of our dairy to feed their mother lord.
Directly in that bartender's eye last time, remember?
Well, the other one still works.
Whoa. If there's one thing I know, it's that you can always trust the US government.
Everything's gonna be perfect, right?
Hello and welcome to OneX!
I'm Kit Kringel.
And I'm Allison Howlett, and we are your student producers for OneX 2023.
We are so excited to be able to produce One Acts for the second year in a row. One Acts is RM one act plays that we put on for one night only. There are four of them. They are all student produced, student written, student crewed. All of the proceeds from tonight go directly to the Richard Montgomery Black Maskers Drama Club.
The directors, producers, stage managers, actors, and crew are all RM students. We cannot be prouder of the incredible work that they have done tonight. Thank you all for coming out tonight to support our amazing students.
Before we get started, just there are a few housekeeping reminders. First, please silence and put away all electronic devices, and remember that flash photography is strictly prohibited during the performances.
In the unlikely case of an emergency, please note the emergency exits near you. Our actors use the aisles throughout the performance, so please keep the aisles clear. As noted in the program, this production uses flashing lights and loud noises.
There will be a light show and dancing by our running crew after our second one act, followed by a brief 10-minute intermission where we will be selling concessions in the lobby. All proceeds from the concession sales go directly towards supporting the arts here at RM.
Finally, we would like to thank the amazing people who made tonight possible. Thank you to our wonderful assistant producers, Susanna and Aarushi, and our incredible stage managers, Annyee and Isaac. You are a dream to work with, and we can't wait to see all of the amazing work you do next year.
Thank you to the directors and writers of these shows for sharing your creativity and talent with us. Thank you to the teachers that let us hold your rooms hostage for rehearsals. We appreciate your patience and generosity. And of course, thank you to the amazing crews for bringing these shows to life.
And last, but so far from least, thank you to our incredible sponsor, Mr. Rodney. He has been an amazing technical supervisor, mentor, and friend, and we are so grateful for the many years he's given our drama club. This is his last one acts, and we couldn't be prouder to be part of his legacy and his acting debut. Thank you, Mr. Rodney, for everything you've done for the drama community. We love you.
And lastly, thank you all for supporting the One Acts Festival. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy the show!
by. Our lovely, talented, amazing cast for contributing all of your amazing ideas.
The producers and stage managers for making our dreams come true. Love you guys.
And the wonderful stage crew for making our vision come to life. We're both super excited to be standing up here. Directing a play together has truly been one of the most memorable experiences of our lives. And we will never forget it.
It really is an honor to be able to tell this silly little story with so many incredible people, especially Nitya, who took this crazy leap of faith with me. I really could not have done it without any, we couldn't have done it without like all of the support. It takes a village. While we're on the topic of thank yous, thank you to my hairdresser for giving me all the emotional support.
What?
The McDonald's employee that gave me not one, but two extra nuggets. That guy that dropped off a lot of cheese in my house. I don't know where you buy that much cheese.
Chloe, it's not American. Please. Chloe, come on, we have to go. The show's about to start.
I still have so many more people to thank.
We don't have time. Enjoy the show.
Is that a deal? Fantastic. I'll invoice you the details. Thank you for putting your trust in Swiss and Chips Incorporated. Another 8 wheels of cheese sold!
Hey. I want to make sure your numbers match mine and are, you know, correct.
Looks good to me.
Thank you, Catherine. Say, have you seen the new guy yet?
Maybe once in passing. Why?
Oh, so you haven't spoken to them? They were at the company dinner last night. They're quite a nice fellow. Apparently just transferred here from elsewhere.
There was a company dinner?
Oh, never mind. Anyways, apparently they've been getting the hang of things very quickly. There must be some kind of natural talent. I guess people are just built differently these days, or something.
Yeah, or something.
Oops.
Hey! Watch it!
High school interns.
Oh, Rip! Make sure you close that bag well when you're done with it. People have reported some pest sightings.
Oh, yeah, I got you. Don't even, like, worry about it.
Hey, Rick! Automate
that thing I told you gets finished.
Don't even worry about it, man. I already got it done.
There's no way that he's actually worked on anything.
He actually finished it yesterday. Oh, look at the time. Meeting is about to start at 15. Boss wants everyone to be there. It's supposed to be important. No idea. See you.
See you. Dear Diary, I've been working at Swiss and Chips Incorporated for as long as I can remember, but I can't shake the feeling that in my professional opinion, something is off. Something about one of my coworkers. Now, this may sound crazy, but hear me out. I think that there's an imposter among us. Somebody is not as they seem. They may be a government spy, or maybe they're an alien sent from space to steal all of our dairy to feed their motherlord. Or maybe they're a bunch of rats in a trench coat. It could be any one of them. Let's see.
Hey, that's Mr. Bossman to you, and I am the boss of things around here.
I'm Brie. I'm the one making sure that here doesn't fall apart. I love Secretary. It's my one and only passion.
What's up? I'm the cool one. They like don't pay me. I am broke.
Hi, I'm Charles.
Am I crazy for thinking this? Well, I guess not. Remember last year when we had that other new guy around the office? Something was definitely up with him too. Swiss and Chips Incorporated is built on integrity and diligence, but I guess that doesn't mean anything to anyone anymore, because last year, Brie kept telling me, "You're making baseless assumptions, and leave this poor guy alone. He's just a random middle-aged man. And stop leaving ominous notes on his lunch saying, 'I know what you are,' or whatever." Ah, right, the meeting. What are they doing here?
We're understaffed today, and I wanted to make the office look busy. Thank you, Swiss and Chips Incorporated employees, my little cheesecakes, my cheddar chums, my Gouda pals.
We get it.
For coming to this very important meeting. You know, my wife used to call me her cheddar chum before she left me. Now, I am sure you are all aware that you are the most valuable asset here at Swiss and Chips Incorporated. And I love each and every one of you dearly. Now, I am sure you are all aware of our employee of the year. No. Ever. Employee of the ever. Of all time. I could never imagine having to choose an employee every month. Am I right?
Am I right? Yeah.
I mean, that sounds like something I would have to choose, and I should. But in all honesty, I don't know who to choose. It's because I appreciate you all equally, not because I have never paid attention to you ever. Now, this time, I've decided that we should play a little game, and I want you guys to vote on who you want to win. It'll be like a competition. Hey, who will emerge victorious? You get me, don't you, Alyssa?
My name is Rebecca.
Who do you think you'd vote for?
Well, honestly, myself. It's the most practical thing, right? In case nobody else votes for me, I'll still have a chance. Isn't that what everyone else does anyways?
I was thinking more of like, you know, voting for someone that you think is genuinely qualified and has an outstanding performance. But that makes sense too. What about you guys?
I'm not too sure. I don't know if I know anyone well enough personally yet, so I'll probably just stick to someone whose professional ethic I can admire.
I'll vote for whoever actually does their job well.
Hey, I do my job well.
Meeting adjusted. What's the word? Meeting over! I'm sure you all have lots of relevant things to do. I hope you all still want to work for our company after this. We really cannot afford to lose any employees right now.
Charles has done great work recently.
They've got a lot of spirit.
And they're like really good too. I heard they even managed to sell cheese to Donald Reagan himself this morning. Imagine the charisma.
As reliable as the red alder, the most useful tree for medicine that can grow nearly anywhere thanks to its shade intolerance.
What?
What? Oh, forgive me. I must remember something I read in a field journal.
To What? Charles? What is so great about this guy? They've barely been here a week, and everyone is already drooling all over them. It took me so long to earn the respect of my coworkers. They do respect me, right? That's besides the point. I just know that something is definitely up, and I'm not gonna let some new guy upstand me like this, especially if they really are a pest. I bet they're eating away at our cheese stash this very second. Mark my words, I'll find you, Charles, if that's even who you really are.
Thanks for the drinks, guys. That was very kind of you.
Shit, don't mention it. Especially to the boss. He's going to make drinks for him every day. Right now. Over by a car. Torn up by a rabbit peg of rats. And then frozen by the bank.
Whoa. This is, like, so good. I'm glad that I settled on the peppermint mocha.
Oh, I thought it was called the Super Duper Minty Magic Chocolate Swirl Creamy Mocha Latte on the menu.
No, I don't think so.
Oh, shoot. Give me a moment.
Oh, hi, Catherine.
Cheddar, Jesus Christ. You scared me.
Oh, sorry. I don't think that we formerly met. I'm Charles. Charles. Cheese to meet you.
Trust me. I know. So, what'd you get?
A drink. It's really cool. Look at this cup. Do you want to see?
It's water.
But in a cool cup.
Uh-huh.
Yo, you got to make any crazy cheese sales yesterday?
I didn't do that well. Still in my rookie numbers phase, you know.
That's all right. Nobody starts off with crazy numbers in the beginning.
You know. I helped Ella Motzer make her seventh sale.
I actually did 492 sales, a personal record.
Charles?
I just did 501.
Nice. That's a lot of wheels of cheese. Who is buying all this cheese anyway?
So, let's talk about you.
You got any hobbies? Oh, I don't know. Cooking? They say anyone can cook.
Not particularly. I mean, I haven't tried. Anything you recommend for a first timer?
I don't know. Maybe something French? Like toast?
I've never had it. That sounds fun.
You got any other hobbies?
You know, mazes and the like. Running. But the kind where you stay in one place.
You mean on a treadmill?
Sort of. But the kind that goes in a circle.
Dang! Didn't know you were a workout kind of guy. A real gym rat, eh?
Ooh, what makes you say that? I'm telling you, this new model will be great. Business is like camping. You need to learn to survive and adapt with the time. Please, please, pull at my grasp. As you can see, red touching black, save for Jack, red touching yellow.
Okay, well, my name isn't Jack, so I don't see how this applies to me. Also, I don't have the time, and I don't really care. Also, what's with this weird camping analogy? It's weird, because, like, no one cares about camping except you. It's like, what, you know, a lifelong dream of wanting to be a Boy Scout or something?
So what if I do?
And the results are in. For Rick, Shenersi, Elamatzer, Elizabetta, etc. Etc. Other employee names. All 0 votes. And with 2 votes is Cass!
Yes! Yes! I can't believe that someone else voted for me! I mean, of course they did! I humbly accept...
And with 7 votes, Sean!
Oh, rats! This can't be happening to me! I am a professional! This is it! It's time for the plan! Where does she keep getting that diary from? Hello? I must be early. OMG! Cheese! Who would waste perfectly good cheese like this? I guess somebody has to clean it up. Actually, a bunch of rats in a trench coat pretending to be a person. They led a total fraud into our beloved Swiss and Chips Inc. A literal rat! Isn't that shocking?
Not really. We kind of figured the whole time.
You guys knew? Then why didn't you say anything?
To be honest, I didn't care. Sure, they acted sketchy at times, but they do their best. Isn't that enough?
But it's still not fair.
What is?
Well, it feels like they're cheating. They're still so much better than me at my job.
Does that really matter? We're all working at the same company. Do you have to be number one all the time?
A little.
No use wasting time thinking of everyone who's better than you. Some things in this world just... like, aren't worth dwelling on. Like, when you use a public toilet, and you think of all the bodies that have touched that seat. It's gonna be the same no matter how hard you think about it. Unless they find a way to untouch toilet seats, which I think I'd be able to lead a better life in general. But until then, we use toilet paper to do what we can, and we move on.
There are so many other ways you could have explained this to me. But, thanks. I think I know what I should do now. Hey, you're wiser than I thought.
Thanks?
I don't understand why you wouldn't show off your wisdom more. I bet you'd get much more respect from people.
Oh, please. They can perceive me however they want. Who am I trying to impress, you know? I do what I can, when I want to.
I don't know how much time we have left. We've got to find Pest Control Prison and get in somehow.
I think I've got a plan. You know anything about tying knots?
My time has come! Finally, somewhere I can apply my interests. As I say, scout, testament, help a friend, fix a cat, help a rat.
Welcome to Spirit. Let us be as resilient as a red alder and get through this together.
Oh, how do you remember that?
All right, guys, we've got a rat to save! Charles! Or I guess it'd be Charles singular now? Charles!
You scared me!
Oh, hi, Captain. I'm here to help you escape. Look, I'm sorry.
It's okay. I get it. It's not your fault.
But it is. I shouldn't have ratted you out for being a rat.
Why did you assume that I'm a rat and not a mouse?
Oh, shoot. Are you a mouse?
No. I was just curious.
Look, I'm really sorry. Rick helped talk some sense into me, and I realized that I was just jealous.
Jealous? Of me? But why? You're incredible.
Incredible? But I can't even compare myself to you getting into things so quickly like that. I guess it's just that I've always felt like I've worked so hard to build my way up in this company. And yet, I still don't really feel like I'm doing enough. I don't get recognition from the boss, and I don't get invited to company dinners. But I had accepted that, and knew that if I kept working hard, I would eventually prove that I could make it. And yet, here you are. A new employee out of nowhere, and a week into your work, you're suddenly the talk of the office. Everyone loves you. You're great at your job.
They do? I didn't know. I guess I was so focused on trying not to get my identity exposed that I never really noticed. It was naive of me to expect the jig to last forever.
Actually, our coworkers said that they already knew and didn't really care. So turns out I was the problem.
About what you said, about hard work, I get where you're coming from. I felt like I always needed to be perfect the first time to prove something, I guess, to prove that I could belong. It was an enormous burden.
Turns out we weren't so different after all.
Yeah.
Look, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have assumed such things. Man, if we just worked together from the start, we could have helped each other out. I should have done this so much earlier, but friends? Oh, it's Brie and Rick. It's time to go. Let's get you out of here.
They came to help too? Wait, but what about you?
Don't worry about me. I'll stay to make the guards less suspicious. I think I'd make a pretty convincing rat. Meow.
Okay. Anyways, I don't want to leave you behind like this.
It really is okay. I'm the one that messed up. It's the least that I can do.
What? Hey, how are you lifting me up?
Didn't I tell you? I'm a gym rat.
Lift us up, Brie and Rick. Goodbye, past prison.
Catherine, Charles, you're okay. Or would it be Charles singular now?
I can't believe you guys came back for me.
It's the least we could do.
So, So, where do we go from here?
Well, I don't know if I can return to work exactly.
I could get you in. I don't think Boss has even heard of the whole fiasco yet. If I deleted a few voicemails and threw away some newspapers, I'm sure he wouldn't even realize.
Hey, did you guys ever, like, find it weird that the boss made us vote on Employee of the Ever? I mean, I guess that in itself isn't the strangest thing, but I feel like they always pit us against each other. Not to mention they continually brush off Brie all the time, right?
Yeah.
That is, like, so messed up, bruh. We shouldn't stand for this. I say we stage a coup and overthrow this injustice.
Yeah, let's go!
Funny to see you guys here, my precious employees. Ah, you must have missed my memo, because I may or may not have just sent it. But I am going on a short break. My aunt, my poor aunt, is stranded in Bora Bora at a horrifying resort with a wretched pool and terrifying free drink service. As you can imagine, I must rescue her immediately. But no journey is ever easy, and I do not know when I will make my courageous return.
Yes, get out of here.
Well, I guess that's another way to get rid of your evil tyrant. We all agree that he's not coming back, right?
Yeah.
Brie, would you be opposed to being our boss, pro tempore?
Honestly, it would be nice to have a chance to restore some order around here.
I have a few ideas already.
Say, boss? What's new? What's first on our brand new agenda?
Celebratory company dinner? Anyone?
That would be fantastic.
Joe's Comedy Hour. Hey! Yeah, all right. Before we get started, I wanted to talk about something pretty serious, though. Last week, I was in a pretty dark place. Then the movie finished and the lights came on. Hey! Oh, hey! Okay. Get this, right? I once saw a wasp push open the door and exit. I couldn't believe it. Hey, I'm just messing with you. All right, yeah.
Joseph, what are you doing?
Joe's Comedy Hour. Yeah.
Anyway, sorry I'm late. Extra part of crime. There was a drive-by egging.
Oh, what?
Well, I saw somebody throw an egg at somebody else. I bet it has nothing to do with the show that's about to happen.
What show? Oh, you mean this thing we made to honor the time-honored tradition and medium known as a sitcom?
Yeah, the thing we did with the help of the greatest people of all time. We'd like to spotlight the incredible Mr. Davis, Mr. Goldstein, Mr. GK, and Dr. Perry for providing us with rehearsal spaces. We'd also like to recognize the stupendous cast of this upcoming episode, as well as the many crews behind the magic of 1X. And of course, Mr. Rodney.
We'd also like to thank Gavin.
Yeah, Gavin!
That's a bit much. If you have questions about the show or anything, now is not the time. We created the greatest show of all time. And now you're going to watch it. Cue the music. Jokes, huh?
Yeah!
Alright. So, let me tell you. Anyone out there Australian tonight in the crowd?
Good day, mate!
We're good.
Ticket? For what?
Oh, nothing. Only the greatest show of all time. You don't mean, oh, I mean, you mean, well, what are we waiting for? Let's go. Guys?
There's a slight problem. We only have one ticket.
What? Only one ticket?
So I guess that means I'll have to see the show by my lonesome tonight.
Wait a minute, Ivy. I don't think that's right for your ticket to have.
The ticket's mine. I found it.
You mind telling us where you found it?
Well, you know, I found it in your dresser.
Wait, Lockie's dresser's in my room. That means the ticket's mine.
Well, it's your room, but it's my apartment. That means the ticket's mine.
Norville, you don't even live here.
Well, you know what they say!
All right. We have one ticket and four people.
Ticket five!
No!
The nerve! Let the door hit you on your way out! Do you seriously have to lug that thing around everywhere you go?
Shai,
what's in the box anyway?
It's nothing! It's just, packing peanuts. Why do you carry around a box full of packing peanuts?
I don't think you can send me to pack something.
As I was saying, there's just no way to split this ticket game.
Scissors?
How about playing for it?
With the game of cards? Not after what happened in that last game of Go Fish. I had to walk out into the bathroom for a week.
I still have nightmares.
I know. Why don't we play rock, paper, scissors for it?
No. If you're gonna make me play a game for my ticket, then it's going to be a game of skill. Why not a game of darts?
Are you serious? Not after last time. You threw that dart directly into that bartender's eye, remember?
Well, the other one still works.
Okay, this is just not gonna work. What time does the show start, Lockie?
Precisely 20 minutes.
Then you have to choose to get this ticket fast.
I'm not getting that.
What do you mean you're not getting that?
I mean, I'm not getting it.
Well, I got it last time, so I didn't want you to get
it. It's on each
turn, the cycle goes Rockman, then Casey, then Eileen, remember?
I don't think we ever agreed to that.
You didn't agree to. Because you never do anything.
People, stop your bickering!
I can get the phone for you.
No, you can't get the phone, you can see that stupid catchphrase.
Well, you can't stop me!
Eileen, get the phone, they're going for it!
Norville, don't do this. It's the third time this week.
Well, you know what they say!
Do you have to do that every time?
Yes! It defines who I am!
Well, try being someone else once in a while. Will ya? Woo! Someone like Chimney?
So, are we going to decide to get this ticket, or should I just take it for myself?
Whoa, we're playing for it, you scoundrel. It's been decided.
Yeah, but you guys better not cheat.
I promise. Why don't we start the most skillful game known to man? Uno!
All right, so what rules are we playing?
You seriously don't know how to play Uno?
Of course I do. I mean, are we stacking plus twos? Or are we stacking plus fours and twos? Or none at all?
We always stack plus twos and plus fours. Everyone knows those are the rules.
No. You can stack plus twos, but not fours. That's how we always do it.
I'm reading the instructions just to be clear. We have to play this game seriously with something this big on the line.
Fine. Have it your way. Let's just waste more time, shall we? This expedition has gone on long enough, and we haven't gotten anywhere.
Aha! Right here. When a plus card is played,
The player loses their turn and must draw the number of cards specified.
What? Give me that. What it can't be. What other lies have I been told all my life? That America was a true democracy. But my vote still matters, right? Yeah, not really. That can't be true. If there's one thing I know, it's that you can always trust in the US government. Kaboom. Kapow.
Skip. Skip me again and I'll serve you sunny side up. Ha! For this ticket, I won't go over easy.
Kapow. Plus four, baby. Aw, come on.
Whatever you do, don't change it to red. Eileen has all red.
I'll change to red.
Skip again. Another skip. I mean, are the ball you have?
Maybe.
Bluey. Uno! I saw his card. He had green. Keep it red!
Yes! I win! Kiss that ticket goodbye!
Wait a minute! You didn't say Uno. You cheating buffoon! You have to draw two!
No, I did say it. I swear! It's in here.
Oh, Eileen. Not even in the script! Sit back down!
Gotcha now.
Ha! Game one goes to me. Looks like you'll be the one kissing that ticket goodbye, Eileen. Eileen, I thought all that time in the FBI would have taught you some common sense.
Common sense? I look like one common coin.
Lights!
Lucky, what the heck are you doing?
It's as Casey said. Game one goes to death. But you might also remember, it was Casey who picked game one as well.
So
I figured, if that's how we're doing it, then I get my specially pick in two. Welcome to Dark Hide and Seek. It's like hide and seek, but it's in the dark.
Fine. Let's get this over with then, Lachlan. How are we doing this?
We each have 30 seconds, everybody hard. Last one caught win. Win the game, and you'll be one step closer to winning a ticket to the greatest show there has ever been. 3, 2, 1, go! Lachlan, make room. Find your own damn hiding spot. I can't hear you. It's too dark in here. We're gonna hide. Why is this place so small? Where are the walls? Hey, Rocky. Shh. I don't want to get caught. But Lachlan,
what?
Who's seeking? Oh. Well,
Lachlan, you dolt! What kind of game is this?
Get out of here, Lachlan. We're gonna restart. Well, technically, I see you two out in the open, so that means I win.
How? There are no rules to this game. We didn't even choose who's seeking.
Well, it's my game, so I'm seeking.
You just can't do that.
The rules are the rules. I don't want to hear complaining.
Found you!
Norville? Where did you even come from?
I had to run a quick errand.
Something's different about you. Well, you know how they say errand running cleanses the spirit? Probably got something to do with that.
Wait, doesn't that mean that Norville wins?
What? I was seeking, remember?
What was it you said? I don't want to hear complaining.
Hey guys, I just wanted to tell you that—
Get out, Garrett! What times do we have to tell you?
I can't believe that guy!
serious, even after the incident?
I can assure you, although horrific, their families were compensated equitably for the unfortunate accident.
As my good friend Plato would proclaim, good people do not need laws to tell them to act responsibly, while bad people will always find a way around the law.
Plato? That moron created the theory of four. Who the heck cares what he thinks?
Well, you know what they say!
All right, let's get this over with. I'm going first, and I don't care what you have to say about that. I decided. Let's see a bullseye!
Nice try, Casey. But that was a total flop.
I mean, it was a four. It was not that bad a score. Well, it's not. If you're trying to lose a ticket, that is, I'll show you how a real man throws a dart. Hee-yah! Well, I guess now we know how a real man throws darts.
Alright, my turn.
Norville, what wacky hijinks are you going to partake in this time?
Wait and see.
But I certainly did not expect that.
Well, I guess we saved the best for last. Watch and learn.
We are never playing darts again!
That means I win again! Oh, this ticket is as good as mine!
Are you serious? No one won! We've just watched Arlene commit multiple felonies with a single dart! What is your first thought about the ticket?
Well, you know what they say!
My next dart is coming in your direction!
Well, I don't feel that's a valid threat. You'd end up missing me and triggering a bunch more sound effects.
Norville, I believe it's your turn to choose a game to decide the fate of our ticket.
Well, I've come up with a game of my own. A true and final challenge to our gauntlet. Whoever stands on one leg the longest wins.
That's it? That's too easy. Are you serious?
Serious as Harry Potter's uncle?
Well, let's hit the sharp one. It's an odd game, but I suppose it works. Eileen, would you like to count us off?
We're going on the count of 10. 1, 2, 10! How about a friendly wager on who gets out first?
Ooh, a shy bet? I'm in. I come from a long line of drunks, crooks and gamblers. $5 says Norville gets out first. I'm in too. $20 on me coming in first.
Well, I'll put $30 on me coming in first. Deal?
Deal.
Deal.
Well, all right, Norville. Are we just supposed to stand here all day?
Attack!
Attack? What do you mean, attack?
Don't hurt me. I haven't written my will yet.
Well, it's a good thing you feel it thorough!
You never said anything about throwing things.
All I said was stand on one leg the longest. I never said how.
Well, in that case, Casey, I should have known you would have pulled a dirty trick like this. I'm sorry, Lachlan. It was either me or you. Well, who cares anyway? I'm trying these dumb things again. Do you care? Forget why you're playing these dumb games, did you? Oh no, the ticket! What have I done?
Norma, stop throwing stuff at me! You're not gonna win!
My dad and I are winning!
I'm not trying to win! I'm trying to take you out!
Oh, how the mighty have fallen. Any patient? I guess I did better than you.
Yeah.
Bailey, I'm sure you're so proud of yourself.
Come here, Nora.
Oh, no, you don't! No.
Why do you even want this ticket anyways? I told you already. It's not about the ticket! Are these? Eggs?
So it seems the raw truth has finally come out.
It was you! You were the drive-by egger!
Well, did you long enough to realize you dense cabbage? Who do you think it was who poured water all over your khakis at that weird French restaurant? Then who do you think shaved male pattern baldness in your hair while you slept? You couldn't see that one smoothie the day after. And that errand I had to run a few minutes ago, I was making sure that Tiffany, the newest flake in your life, couldn't have booked Mongolia, so I wouldn't have to compete with her either. Come on, Eileen. Why don't you ask me to go with you anywhere anymore? Go with you and me again.
Why did you say so? I didn't know you felt that way. You know there's no way I'd let some random guy get in between of what we have. I'd love to go anywhere with you. In fact, I think there's still time for us to catch a show. Together. If you want to, that is.
Oh, of course I want to! But we don't have two tickets.
Hey guys, I was just wondering if you wanted this ticket to... that I have. I can't make it tonight.
Well, why didn't you say anything before?
Oh, I'm sorry. I guess that's my bad. I can't make it tonight because I have to go to the emergency room. I can see you're all rushing to find out why I have to go to the emergency room, so I guess I'll just tell you. Hold on one second. My Adam's apple fell out! I think I sneezed funny or something, and it just came flying out. I thought it might have been the apple I swallowed whole earlier today. But that one was a Granny Smith.
So it wouldn't have made sense.
On the other side of that. And what about that dot I leaned through? Is everyone alive? Also, how'd the ticket end up in my room in the first place? Who put it there? How did we even keep track of the games we played to win the ticket? Did none of what just happened matter at all? Who won? Ah, who cares? We won.
Best buds.
Best buds.
You know what they say!
Howlett's short lights show and the dance performance from our running crew. After this, I will be support the Black Masters Club. We will resume the show after.
Whichever should happen first. Then, they'll be paid and can go on their way. You will be the only one they interact with. I'll be here, observing and taking notes, and I'll be able to see them, but they will not be able to see me. All good?
Yes, sir.
You know, time was, we used to do experiments that were dangerous and exciting, not this sort of rubbish.
Oh.
Yes, I remember once, back in the 90s, I supervised an experiment that left two people dead. Oh boy, those were the days. Nowadays, it's all just observe this, observe that. If you told me then that 30 years down the line, I'd be preparing to watch four high school kids play a board game, I'd have spat in your face and called you a liar.
Ah.
Not that they let us do that sort of thing these days. God forbid a psychologist should propose an experiment that might actually be interesting. No, it's all just waivers and consent, terms and conditions now. I'm an old man. I've had my fun. Forgive me for talking about my glory days.
Some show. Well, here we go. I can't wait to get started!
there. Just what I wanted to do. It's just psychology. I don't know what that is, but I'm very good at pretending I do. My acting skills are coming through. It's all a genius way against the money that will pay for the success of me. I just got no way to change.
So I won't leave you in suspense any longer. Just let me get the necessary equipment. Oh, not this. Sorry. Oh, not this either. Where is the darn thing? Ah, here.
Your task is simple. You're going to play Monopoly, either until somebody wins or until 2 hours elapse, whichever happens first. You will all be paid at the end, and if somebody wins, you will get a $50 bonus. Have fun.
I called in from the thimble.
Excuse me?
The thimble. It's my lucky Monopoly piece. I can't play as anything else. If I did, it just feels so wrong. You know, what piece do you play as?
Oh, I don't play board games. I have, what's it called? Oh yeah, a life.
I can be this horse.
Unless this is a variant of Monopoly with which I am unfamiliar, I believe what you just referred to as a horse is in fact a dog.
This is going to be a long 2 hours.
Well, if your goal is to exit the experiment as quickly as possible, I suggest you simply give all your money to me and declare bankruptcy. Then I will win.
Never! I came here to win and I won't leave until I've won. Are you all going to give up now when we haven't even begun? Or will you stay and fight? Fight the cowardly impulses which tell you to flee from hardship and difficulty and instead put everything you have plus a little bit more to win this game? Oh, the choice is yours, friends.
First of all, I am not your friend. Okay, enough of these meaningless arguments. Let's begin. I'll be the top hat and you can be the ship. I'll go first. Doubles! What luck! Vermont Avenue. I'll purchase it. The senator of Vermont is, after all, my hero. Okay. Let me go. Again. Doubles again!
No!
An orange. Did you know that it's been mathematically proven that oranges are the best in Monopoly? I'll have to purchase it. Let me go again. A 5 and a 6. Madison Gardens. Don't mind if I do purchase it. Oh, what a turn, what a turn.
My turn. These must be good dice. Let's get something good. Come on, come on, come on. 3 and a 1? Oh, let's move. income tax, pay $200? I hate my life so much sometimes. This is actually so unfair.
You know, Immanuel Kant once said that there is nothing unfair about bad luck. So, you know. After. 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Dance. Advance to boardwalk.
Do you want to purchase it?
No thanks.
All right, my turn.
Oh, not so fast. Now boardwalk goes up for auction. My favorite part of Monopoly. Any bids?
I guess I'll just pay the full price. 400?
Oh, 400. And one.
All right, I can do 450.
450s. One.
You want to fight or something, bro? I don't mess with you. You shouldn't mess with me. Chill out.
Well, if no one else has anything, I guess mine.
Fine, I'll pay 600, huh? What are you gonna do now?
600. And what?
800.
800? And one!
1,000!
You fool! Now you have to pay $1,000! You'll have nothing left! Go on, pay! See, that's the thing about these jocks. They think they're so big and strong, but really, they have no brain! Go on! Pay me!
Oh, you'll be the one who pays.
Oh my God, what did you just do? He's dead! No!
Don't you think we should wait until the experiment has concluded? It looks like it may
finally begin the interesting outcome you've been dreaming of. Think of the report you could write. And besides, if he really is dead, then an ambulance won't do anything.
I suppose waiting a little longer couldn't hurt.
Truly.
How do you feel about all this? Sir?
I feel about this. What do you think you are, my psychologist?
Well, I must admit, it is a little worrying.
As far as I can see, there's only one question that needs to be answered.
That's just what I was thinking.
Question, one question.
Well, who gets the money?
Money and back to you, and I don't really want to spend it.
mention it, it makes so much sense. Why should every disagreement be so intense? What happened to calm and pleasant conversation?
Yes, this is what I've been telling you. I'm so excited that you get into. Why is every interaction an altercation? Why not agree to disagree? It's the best way to do it.
What is happening?
Agree to disagree. If it's okay with you, then it's okay with me.
I like blue.
And I like red. But that doesn't mean we wish the other person were dead. We want to agree on everything you see. But we'll agree on this. Agree to disagree. And I can see the universe written in the sky. I know why I've been disagreeing wrong for all my life. I never will again. I see the light and the
thank you.
like an onion, cause an onion does nothing unless you die just thinking about it.
Show about history. such a surprise that everyone always dies. Everything makes more sense once you realize that.
Can I get the twinkly little lights, please?
But today was supposed to be a day of fun and merriment, a harmless psychological experiment. But what do you know? Everyone is dead now, and I'm next to going, so everyone always dies. I don't know.
We're not.
so goodbye. Now it's time for us to skip away.
Enjoyable, they'd be fun acts. If they're moving quickly, they'd be run acts. If we're forced away, it'll be shun acts. If we're victorious, we'll one acts. If we're conquered, it'll be by Attila the Hun acts. If they weigh 2,000 pounds, they'll be the ton axe. All right, guys, help us out here a little bit. If it's in a bakery, it'll be the bun axe. If this speech was the whole show, it'll be the pun axe. If we freeze, it'll be the stun axe. If it's really bright, it's because of the sun axe. If this was the sound of music, they'd be the nun axe. If we turn around, it'll be the spun axe. Okay, well, that's all the puns Joe could think of. We were supposed to add a little bit more to kill some time, but as far as we can tell, Joe used them all up.
So I guess there's nothing to do, but I mean, thank some people or whatever. I mean, that's kind of boring, but okay.
If we must, we must. First, we'd like to thank our wonderful cast. They put so much hard work into this production. We are so thankful for all their dedication to the show, and we are so proud of how far they've come. Thank you, Emma, Lily, Ella, Val, Sam, and Brory. There are no other people we'd rather have taken this adventure with, and it was a big adventure.
Also, a special shout out to Emma, who plays Steve. You won't be able to tell, but she actually got the script for the first time 10 days ago. Thank you, Emma, for working so hard. You are so amazing, and thank you so much.
We'd also like to thank our wonderful producer team, Allison, Kit, Rushi, and Susanna, and the wonderful stage managers, Isaac and Annie. Thank you for all your support and hard work behind the scenes to keep us all going.
To all the crews, thank you for all of your support and helping make this show come to life. It has been an amazing experience working with you all. We truly cannot have done any of this without you. And also thank you to Dr. K and Miss G. Thank you for letting us use your rooms to rehearse on your own time and always providing us with snacks upon request.
We appreciate you all so much. Thank you for staying on your own time. We are eternally grateful. We also have to extend a massive thank you to Casey, who actually wrote this one act. Unfortunately, she could not be here tonight as she lives in Arkansas. But we wanted to thank her for letting us produce her play. Congrats, Casey, on having your play produced.
And last, but certainly not least, we have one more person to thank.
Oh my goodness, how could we forget? To our wonderful and not at all grumpy sponsor with a superfluous E, Mr. Rodney. Mr. Rodney does so much for not only this club, but the school as well. He is the reason all of this keeps going, and we are so thankful for all his hard work. From voluntarily hanging out with a club of 200 teenagers to giving us all nicknames. Guys, sorry, my phone just died. and even keeping the floppy disk and the lighting board going, he is truly the reason this club is what it is today.
This is his final one-act festival with Black Maskers. Rodney, We are honored to have worked with you for your last one act, and we are honored to actually be the last one act and to call ourselves your directors. Thank you for all your help in putting this together. You have been with us from the very beginning of this process, and we hope to make you proud. One Acts would not be where it is today without you. We all love you so, so much, and we're so thankful for everything you have done for us. We can't wait to see your acting debut at RMHS. And now that we've thanked everyone, it's the Done Acts. Also, the first person to correctly guess the number of Taylor Swift references in this show gets $100. Find us after the play.
Enjoy the show.
Agent Steve, what are you doing?
Agent Pete, it's very nice to meet you. You're shorter than I thought you'd be. You told me to wait orders outside the house. I figured we needed to be discreet.
Right. Discreet. Operation Mayday. Hide these folders. Be sure to. We aren't safe here, Steve. We need to find the Almighty before it's too late.
Roger.
My name is Pete.
I've been keeping major tabs. Very thorough. I've even planted cameras all around the house to keep watch. There's one in that flower bush right there. Pretty cool, huh?
It will rain at 7. The birds fly high tomorrow. The snake slivers calmly. Think, how many steps does it take to get there?
How many? The snake? It takes 6 blocks to get there. The snake sleeps calmly.
Home early?
Oh, I didn't mean to.
No biggie, you've had a long week.
Oh, Pete held me over. You know how he is.
He's still coming over tonight?
At 6. Won't be a hair late. Come on, let's get ready. We've got a lot on our plate.
They look a little dry, don't they?
Oh, they're succulents.
They're flowers.
Really? Oh.
It's crazy I'm just now hearing of this Pete. Is it Mr. or Doctor? Such an impressive man, traveled the world and back, still has time for the wife and kids, head of his own investment firm. Couldn't dream that up. To think, you're really moving up in the world. What's his favorite drink? I'll be quick stop at the drugstore. We want him to feel at home, don't we?
Oh, it's,
his favorite drink?
For sure. I mean, I couldn't tell you his favorite, but he does have a knack for dairy. Very particular.
His milk can't be anything but whole. He asked his intern
to grab him some. And sharp cheddar cheese. Anything else is for softies.
Milk?
Not just any milk, Abby. Whole milk. He'll throw the jug in your face if it's anything else. Very particular man. Longtime colleague and friend.
Steve, I heard you. But milk?
And?
Steve!
I'm saving us! He can smell it from the porch. He'll know. Trust me.
It's unopened.
It's 2%! That is a full 98% away from whole. Only 2%? Oh, that was a massacre in the making, and I just prevented it.
Fine. I will get some new milk.
Just don't burn the Colby Jack.
Colby!
I said don't.
Fine. I can stay.
I just cleaned the place up. We have guests coming tonight. Don't make it worse.
Whatever happens, happens. If you're hearing this, I'm dead. A snake, too.
He knows. Agent Pete was supposed to assist me on a mission. Not because I'm not capable.
For the purpose of observation, obviously. I mean, it is my first mission with the agency. Almighty has yet to show. At this point, we haven't found him. He hasn't revealed himself. But I know he will. Soon. Because I know he's on to us.
The security camera isn't where I left it.
Agent Pete and I made a plan to draw him in, but if you're hearing this, it didn't turn out well. Agent Pete left the instructions. Look inside the room. You'll know the one I'm talking about. Inside lies the answers. All will be revealed.
What are you gonna do now, huh?
Where's your broom? I can help.
I'm sorry.
The camera, you dropped it?
Oh, and it slipped out of my hand and I... Who are you?
You can call me Pete. I'm here for Steve. And you must be...
Abigail.
Oh, yes, I've heard your name around.
Around where?
From Steve. You're married, aren't you?
Oh, yeah, kind of things you should say about me. Nothing bad, I hope.
Oh, nothing short of lovely.
I'm glad to hear it. Would you care to come in?
I would never come in uninvited.
Fumbling about somewhere. Probably counting the bristles on the carpet. You can never tell with him.
Oh, it's an important task. He's a soldier. I'll go help him out.
I told you to stop coming over uninvited.
I'm not uninvited. I left a voicemail.
That's not invited.
It's close enough.
Estate. Look at this. It's chipped away. She needs a new layer ASAP.
I will take your word for it.
You need to. I was just published in the Digest. Architectural. I know cheap paint. I can feel it. Go with the Sherwin next time. BJ Moore is tacky, but it'll do.
What do you want, Rebecca?
A nice chat with my sister.
You could have just called again.
Why wait? I know where you live. I shouldn't have to wait.
You never change.
Why should I?
Forget it. You can stay for dinner. Just this once. Don't start anything. Steve invited the whole office over. You should have some company.
Good. You should too. It's about time you left.
Rebecca!
He's a lousy piece.
Not now. There are guests.
It's a pleasure to meet you, miss.
That's Mrs. to you. You know I'm right.
I know you're not.
Stay alert. If he shows up, you know something's wrong.
If he what? Are you okay? I can get you a glass. Steve told me it's your favorite.
Well, I'm all right. Thank you.
I insist.
Is this whole milk? Thank you so much. It's delicious. I'm just gonna go enjoy this over here.
Rebecca, how's the gardening? Sewing.
Knitting.
You think I knit? What kind of a lowlife do you think I am?
Rebecca, I didn't mean
you to. You know what? I knit. You pig! I have too much purpose in life to spend hours playing with two needles. As a senior writer top in my field, I demand more respect for myself. My people. My gender. I won't let some lazy little mommy's boy say I knit. I would never.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Really, 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 truly, truly sorry. You are above me. You're a goddess. I kneel at your feet.
Forgive me? That's more like it.
What in the... Is that the...
A new foundation you like? It's a little light for me.
Pete here has a wonderful sense of humor. That's why he's my best friend.
What happened to the milk I bought? Did you throw it out? You coward. She deserves better.
Rebecca, let's just... I have a casserole in the oven. I called in some food before I left. Sam's place goes well with the dressing, but it should be here any moment. See? Get the table together.
Yeah. All right. Steve, we're in the final stage. Here's the plan. We need two signatures. You and your ladies. Now, I hate to get the feds involved, but we don't want the Almighty snooping around this place, do we now? I talked to Abigail. She knows. She's acting like she knows nothing, but it's only to protect you, of course. Look here.
Is that a threat? From the Almighty?
No, you idiots! It's a seize indictment! For him! So he stays away from you. Real formal papers you got here.
Went to the court, and May got them. Myself. He'll leave you alone. For good. Hey, isn't it called a seize
indictment? It's Latin, I think.
Yes, Latin. I forgot.
Anyhow, he might be sure. He might be watching. Abigail will act like she doesn't know what all of this is, but it's all part of the plan, of course. Just get her to sign, and after, make sure he's watching, you sign. Simple.
What am I signing?
Oh, nothing too dangerous. Can't talk now. I'll sign over later.
Got it.
Soon, this is all part of the plan.
Is this?
Yes, Robinson, I'll take it.
Of course, your total is, oh! I'm sorry, this is all my fault. Don't worry, just sign this.
Go help him, they're watching.
Oh, let me.
Dad?
What?
You left me! How could you? You built a home, started a family, all without me?
Oh, you! Don't talk to your dad like that.
You don't know me. You didn't even try to.
Your mother and I were so young, and I planned.
You have a child? Lazy. I could take that. Late nights could take that. You ungrateful little. You think. Maybe. After the third date. Maybe. Before we moved in together. Maybe. Even before we got married. You didn't think to tell me that you have a child.
I told you. A mistake. This whole marriage a disgrace.
Abigail. Abby. I promise. This isn't what it looks like.
None of this is what it looks like.
Then what is all this, then?
I thought you knew. Pete told me that you...
Now!
And who are you? What now? His brother, estranged father, ex-husband? Give it up.
Sit down, dear. You know me all too well.
He knows all of us!
I don't care! Get out!
Goodbye, my love. We've lived a long 7 months and 5 days together. Until the other lifetime!
Men and their theatrics, so dramatic.
Dad! What's wrong?
Steve! Just sign it! Look at him out! And you'll be free!
What about Abby?
Steve, look at me. Just sign!
Is that it?
We done?
We done.
Let's go.
Woo! Am I in hell?
No, you're in our house.
I'm calling the police.
No can do!
Unless you want them to arrest you. What are you talking about? Look, two signatures. All we needed. Here and here. Thank you. Since both parties consented, take a look at the fine print, doll.
As witnessed, I declared to hand over
the property that resides on 23 Cornelia Street?
She's ours.
Ours.
But you're, and you're
just some regular folk. I've never seen you before in my life.
We've been living at Pete's mom's basement since our landlord kicked us out for partying too much.
What's with the
get up then.
Got a buddy of mine up east. I could never afford this, but now we got ourselves a place.
All ours.
This was all a ploy?
What are we going to do? You knew about this. How could you?
No, Abby, I didn't.
I hate to interrupt what is clearly an important moment for you two. However, you're in our house, and I was really hoping to try out our new flat screen TV.
You mean my TV?
Actually, it's ours. As it says here, all items inside become ours. But I'll be kind. You can take a suitcase full.
I told you so.
Not the time.
You can stay with me together again.
Oh, thank you so much.
You, not y'all. You.
Find somewhere else to stay. I heard Pete's mom's basement is available.
Abby, you can't possibly.
Steve.
You've got to understand. You started this, and now these men are stealing my home? I want peace, Steve. I know you've been watching me. I found your cameras.
Oh, no, those weren't for you.
And what were they for?
The mission.
What mission? You are delusional.
I can't do this anymore. I'll be at Rebecca's and
you'll be hearing from my lawyers.
So, let me get this straight. All
of this was made up? Man, I spent like 12 hours on that.
Time flies when you're having fun.
Wait, so you're not a spy? I'm not a spy?
I mean, spies aren't usually recruited over snagajob.com.
No.
I gave up everything. She's gone.
Hey.
The world's a cruel place. Gotta do what you gotta do.
Homeless! I'm homeless!
Hey! You don't have to be. I mean, we got a good operation going on.
And you played the part very convincingly. You could join us. See what you could get.
Before we all get caught, at least.
Well, ooh, can I keep my room?
Can you restock the milk and cheese? 2% only. None of that whole milk nastiness. Or you're out. Got it?
Okay, I promise. Got it.
The four of us.
The four of us.
We got a house. We need a car. A motorcycle, maybe? Yeah, I want a hot rod myself.
Come on, buddy, we'll get you a car. We'll get us all cars. You in?
Does that mean I'm a spy again?
Sure, yeah. You're a spy.
Yes! I'm in.
Thank you.
are important here.
If you don't move, I'm gonna drop this on your head.